गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी वेलकम टू टीटीडब्ल्यू आरडीसीडब्ल्यू कोत्तगूडेम वीडियो लेक्चर्स आई एम बी राजेश्वरी वर्किंग एज द डीएल इन कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट टुडे माय टॉपिक इज पाइथन बेसिक्स सो बिफोर गोइंग टू इनसाइड लेट अस सी द एजेंडा पॉइंट्स So in this session, let us know what is Python, why is Python popular, features of Python, where is Python used in the industry, learning paths, career opportunities, as well as simple programs. So what is Python? Python is a general purpose high level interpreted language with easy syntax and dynamic semantics it was created by Guido van Rossum he started this language as fun because he wanted to make the language which is easy to read and in this he used indentations instead of curly brackets where we used in the languages like C C++ Java So he started developing this and but he didn't receive popularity or he didn't receive love because it was slow compared to other programming languages. With the rise of machine learning and artificial intelligence, Python has become popular with easy syntax and very much portability and with an amazing computing power now it is the biggest platform language where many of the developers are using so now why is python popular So let us see one by one. It's the easy syntax. As we said, Python is having easy syntax and high level features make it as best language. And open source. Open source, it is free for anybody to use. Everybody can use with easy syntax. Everybody can use. Even kids can learn Python. So most of the programmers every day get together online for making this Python better and efficient. And you can modify the code, you can create the code, and you can make the code. And you are allowed to do anything without any problems. And it can be used to make almost anything like graphical user interface applications web applications mobile applications server side coding ai ml algorithms anything that have it with you to do and it is having huge library support so high community of people who come together to make the libraries and modules that can be used to obtain a solution Now features of Python. So here we are having many features. Let us see. It's a simplicity. Python has made programming fun because of its simplicity. So it makes concentration on solving the problem instead of syntax. And as we said, its feature is open source language. It is free for anybody. We can do any modifications without any problems. And the most important feature is the portability. Portability supports portability supports Python supports portability, which means we can write code and share it with anybody that you want to, and it would work the same way that run your code. So this makes the movement of projects and systems much more easier. And there are chances that certain languages may perform certain functions better than the Python, but that does not stop you, as Python supports adding code of other languages into itself to run those functions, which makes the Python all the world powerful. And its huge library support helps to obtain solutions for any problems easily. And the most future is the object-oriented concepts. Python allows use of object-oriented concepts which relates to the real-world problems. And real-world problems can be coded, and we can provide security with such features in the object-oriented concept. And where is Python used in the industry? So let us see one by one. YouTube. So the popular YouTube video sharing system is largely written in Python. Google is the most known tech giant to use the Python to provide better search features to its users. And Dropbox is the cloud platform to save the data online. Its clients and server applications have been coded using Python. And Netflix uses Python for their clients, which shows which are recommended for the shows and recommended them longer. BitTorrent is a peer-to-peer file sharing system, begins its life with a Python program. NASA scientists use Python to perform calculations, which helps them reduce time and makes work easier. National Security Agency uses Python for cyber security analysis, encryption and decryption purpose. Let us see the learning path. What are the concepts in this? Variables, data types, operators, arrays, flow control like while, do while, for loop, and if statements, if else statements, methods, which includes functions for doing any task, file handling, where we can read a file, open a file, close a file, write a file, and OOPs concepts like classes, methods, encapsulation, everything. And if you practice the program, you will be the master of this Python language. Let us see career opportunities. So here, web development and frameworks. Web development is one of the option we can choose as a career, where frameworks such as Django helps to build web applications. And game development with the help of Python, by using artificial intelligence, we can create animations, guest posters, and graphics, which gives a better career opportunity. And big data is a booming area where we can detain the data such that we can make the decisions with this big data. And web testing, we can revoke the bugs and make sure that our website is better as much as we need. And some of the fields like artificial intelligence, data science, which gives a long life cycle with many job opportunities by using this Python. And latest technology, IoT, smart devices, can build a better infrastructure by using this Python, which will be a best career opportunity. Now let us come into basic concepts of Python. So firstly, let us see Python variables. So it's here there is a need to compare with our previous languages like C, C++, where we know how the variable is declared. So in C or C++, compulsory we need to declare the data type for a variable. So whereas in the Python, simply the variable is declared as x is equal to 5, y is equal to John. So here we are not having any type declaration. There is no type declaration for a variable. So here whenever we create a variable, at that moment the value is assigned to the variable. So here see, here we can have, here x is equal to 5 and y is equal to John. Here print x and print y. Okay, simply the variable value x is assigned as 5 and y is assigned as John. Yeah, here we can see the output. So by executing this code, we can see the output here. Here x is equal to 5, y is equal to John, print x, print y, and the output after execution, we got the result as 5 and John. So here we need not to declare any type. So here even change type after they have been set. Here suppose x is equal to 4 and x is equal to Sally. Okay, so here even x is of integer, and secondly we set x is equal to Sally. Now x value is now of type string. Automatically it gives the next value Sally, which is a string. So here also we can see the output. So we got the x value as second one Sally. And here we are having option casting, where we can convert the type of variable. So if you want to specify the data type of a variable, here we can use casting. If you want to specify data type, previous case we don't have the data type. Here if you want to specify, we can use casting. So here x is equal to 3, but if you want to specify it as a string, before that string data type is added. So str 3, here x will be a string, single quotes. So y is equal to 3, in before that int is there. Here y is integer type 3, and z is equal to 3, where in before that float is added. So here z value is 3.0. So here if you want to specify the type of a variable, we can use a casting option where it is added before the value. So let us see here the output also. Here print x, print y, print z, we got the values. So string first one, second one integer, third one float value. So how to get the data? So to get the data, that is what type of data you want to see. Further, to get the data, we can use a function type. Type is used to get what type of data we are using. See, for example, here x is equal to 5, y is equal to John. So here actually x is into y is John. But if you want to test whether what type of data it is, we can use a function called type. So here print type of x, print type of y. So let us see the output. Yeah, so here class int, class string. First one is the x is the class of type int. Second one is the class of type string. So here we can also use at the most major important concept is the string can be declared in the single quote or double quote. So unlike our C++ language, single quote means it gives a single character. Double quote means a group of characters which is called a string. But in this Python, there is no single character. Everything is treated as a string. So that's why if the string contains single quotes or double quotes, both the meaning same. See here, we are having x is equal to John within double quotes and next x is equal to John within single quotes. Both are same. Here x is equal to John is same as the x is equal to John. And here one more, the comments can be represented in the Python by using hash symbol. Here we are having hash is the same as, that is comment representation. So now let us see the execution also here. So x is equal to double quotes John print x, and next x is equal to single quote John print x. So for both the print statements, the answer is same, the output is same, John. So that's the meaning is that the string within single quotes or double quotes is the same. And Python is case sensitive. So here the variable names are case sensitive. Example, see here, a small a is equal to 4, capital A is equal to Sally. So here small a and capital A are not the same. Capital A will be overwritten, will not overwrite small a. Okay, so here that's why Python variables are case sensitive. See here, same example, a is equal to 4, a is equal to Sally. Here we print the value of small a and value of capital A. Both are different. So small a remains the value 4 itself. Capital A remains the value Sally itself. Yeah, obviously we are having certain rules for declaring the variable as our C++ languages. So here variable names, it can be a short name like small x, y, or it can be a descriptive name like age, car name, total underscore volume. There are certain rules for Python variables. A variable name must start with a letter or underscore character. It should not be any number or any other special symbols. Definitely a variable has to start with a letter or underscore character. A variable name cannot start with a number. Variable name can only contain alphanumeric characters and underscore like A to Z, 0 to 9 and underscore. And variable names are case sensitive. Here small age and capital age both are different. And capital AGE, these three are different. So Python variables are case sensitive. Next, here let us see some of the legal variable names. So my var equal to John, my underscore var is equal to John, underscore my underscore var equal to John, my capital V are equal to John, capital my var is equal to John. So my var to all these are legal variables. Let us see some illegal variables. To my var equal to John, we should not have a starting character number. And my hyphen var equal to John, we should not use hyphen or minus symbol. My space var equal to John, we should not use a space. And here we can assign many values to multiple variables in a single line. See here, x comma y comma z is equal to orange comma banana comma cherry. So we can assign many values to multiple variables. So here x will be orange, y will be banana, and z will be cherry. So here if you print to x, y, z, we will get the different values. See here, x comma y comma z equal to the values, and print x, print y, print z. Here output is we got the three different values. Okay, so we can declare or we can assign multiple variables with multiple values in a single line. And here we can also assign one value to multiple variables in one line also. So that is x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to orange. So here, so if you print the value x, y, z, all the variables will have the same value, orange, orange, orange. That is, we can assign a single value for multiple variables in a single line. And next, output variable. So to display the value, we use the output variable print. So see here, we have x is equal to awesome, print x. So print x will give the output. And we can also use text. In order to combine the variable with the text, we can use plus symbol. See here, print python is plus x. So here python is a string added with a variable x by using a plus symbol. So here python is awesome. So let us see the output here. See here, x is equal to awesome, print python is and plus x. So we got the output as python is awesome. Next, so we can also use the plus character to add a variable to another variable. So that is example, x is equal to python is, y is equal to awesome is. So z equal to x plus y. If you print the value z, python is awesome. So that is two variables can be added by using plus symbol. Next, here plus also works as a addition operator, mathematical operator addition. Here x is equal to 5, y is equal to 10, print x plus y. You will get the output as x plus 10, 5 plus 10 is 15. We can also add as a, we can also use plus as a addition operator. And here one more important point is we cannot add integer with the string. For example, see, x is equal to 5, y is equal to John, print x plus y, we get the output error because we should not add integer with the string. Okay, so let us see the output. Here we get the output as some error. Okay, we should not add integer with the string value. Now, let us see basic data types, important data types in Python language. So, built-in data types. So, in programming, data type is an important concept. So, variable can store data of different types and different types can do different things. So, Python has the following data types built-in by default. So, in these categories, text type is a string, string data type. Text is represented as a string data type. And numeric types are int, float, complex. Sequence types, list, tuple, range. And mapping type, distinct set. And here some types, set, frozen set. And boolean type is bool. Binary types, bytes, byte array, memory view. Okay, So how to get the data type? As we see in previous, to get the data type, we use a function type. Okay, so example x is equal to 5, print type of x will use the data type. Here in Python, there is no need to declare, there is no declaration, data type declaration, but there is a data type to what type of data the value is holding. In order to know the type of the data, we use a function type. Yeah, so here setting the data type, so we can the value to the variable is set when we assign a value. Here example x is equal to hello world, the type of this x is string. X is equal to 20, it is 20. X is equal to 20.5, it is float. X is equal to 1j, complex. X is equal to in the brackets, apple, banana, cherry, it is a list. And in the parenthesis, apple, banana, cherry, it is a tuple. And range and curly brackets represents the string. And curly brackets represents a set and frozen set, and here boolean true or false is boolean, and bytes be hello, byte array, memory view. So these are different data types. Now Python numbers. So Python numbers basically three types: int, float, complex. So here we create, whenever the value is created, then it represents the type, as we know. So here int means x equal to 1, float is the decimal points, and complex is the j, imaginary part. Okay, and here to know the type of x, type of y, type of z, it gives the which type data we are using. So here type of x is integer number, type of y is float number, and type of z is class complex. Yeah, here the basic difference between our C, C++ languages and Python language is the most and easiest representation is here integer value can be a whole number, either positive or negative, with unlimited length. This is the most important. Coming to the C or C++, we are having many different types: signed integer, unsigned integer, long integer, double, like that. We are having many different types, short into long int. But the simplest, easiest thing is here int means it can be a positive number, it can be a negative number, it can be a whole number, anything, unlimited length. There is no need to worry about the length of the variable. Example C here, x equal to 1, y is equal to a big value, and z is equal to minus value. So here we are checking the type of x, type of y, type of z. If you execute this code, for all the x, y, z, it is of type integer. So let us see here, for three different values x, y, z, the class is integer itself. This is the major simplest thing using the Python. Next, float number. So same way, similar to integer, float also can be a positive, negative, containing decimals. Okay, so here also there is no limit, unlimited length. So x value 1.10, x value 1.0, x value minus the y value, z value minus. So for these three cases also, all is of type float. Complex, coming to the same way. Here one more is, we can also use power of e exponentiation symbol to represent the power of 10, 35e3, so 12e4 minus, so like this is a float value. and complex is having an imaginary part. So here also there is no limitations, everything. And 3 plus 5j minus 5j minus 5j, all are accepted and all are of type complex. Yeah, here we can convert one type of data into another type by using a type conversion concept. So converting one type of data into another type is called as a type conversion. So here we are using some methods like int, float, complex for converting data. Okay, so here we are having x value, y value, z value. In order to convert int to float, before the value we are using the data type float or method float. So here a is equal to float x. Actually here x value is 1, which is integer. In order to convert x value integer into float value, we are using a method float. So a is equal to float x. Here x is converted to float. This is called as type conversion. So here why we are using this variable conversion? What are the methods? Here we are having different constructs. Okay, so here constructor functions int. So int is a constructor function. It constructs an integer number from an integral literal, a float literal, or a string literal, or whatever it is. So by using this int, we can construct any type of literal. And the same way, by using a float, we can construct a integer literal, float literal, or a string literal. Same way, string also, we can construct a wide variety of data types, including string, integer, literals, float, literals. This is type conversion. By using these methods, int, float, string, we can convert the data of one type into another type. Yeah, see here, x is equal to int 1, y is equal to int 2.0. Z is called int, the double quotes, 3. Here, these three values, x, y, z, the three values are converted to integer. Because the method we are using is int itself. So, these three are converted to integer. So, here x will be 1, y will be 2, and z will be 3. Similarly, float. So, here x is called float of 1, x is called float of 2.8, x is called float. Z is called float of 3, W is called float of, everything is converted to float because we are using a type conversion method float. So here all the values will be converted to floating point. Yeah, now the one more important concept is operators, Python operators. Okay, so operators are used for performing many operations on variables and values. See here, we are having a plus operator, which is used to add two values, print 10 plus 5. So which is nothing but adding 10 and 5 will give you a result 15. So here we are having different operators in Python: arithmetic operators, assignment operators, comparison operators, logical operators, membership operators, bitwise operators. So these are a number of operator types. So let us see one by one in brief.